Hello students, welcome to our next video. So in this video we are going to look the topic named as SCR. Okay, so what does the SCR stands for? The SCR stands for silicon controlled rectifier. Okay, SCR. We will be looking the introductory part of the SCR. What is SCR? Basic of SCR structure. How does SCR work? And characteristics curves of SCR. Okay, characteristics curve of SCR, importance of SCR. Okay, so these are the topics we are going to see. So let's start with the introduction part of the SCR. The silicon controlled rectifier, that is SCR. Okay, it is a power electronic device, is unquestionable the greatest interest today. Means it is the great development in the history. Okay, it was first introduced by in 1956 by Bell Telephone Laboratories. It can convert alternating current into direct current. Means means this is the main application of that SCR. So that you can use this is the technology which we need in our applications. Right, it can convert AC into DC. Okay, at the same time it can control the amount of power fed to the load. Means these are the application. Means it can convert AC to DC, DC to AC, and it can also control the power fed to the load. Thus it combines the feature of rectifier and transistor. Means it is a combination of rectifier and transistor. So what is SCR? Means SCR is silicon controlled rectifier. Okay, so SCR is a four-layer. Okay, SCR is a four-layer solid-state device that controls current flow. Means it is a four-layer device which controls the flow of current. Okay, it is a four-layer solid-state device which controls the flow of current. Okay, so SCR is a three terminals. So it has three terminals like anode, cathode and gate. Anode, cathode and gate. Gate, anode and cathode. So the main two uses of SCR, the main two uses widely used are switching operation. Okay, so it is the main application of this SCR. Okay, it is used for switching purpose. Okay, but with the help of this switching only we are going to convert AC into DC or DC into AC. Then the another use of the SCR is amplification. Okay, for amplification purpose, a small or a low strength signal is converted into high strength or larger strength signal. Okay, so what the basic of SCR structure? It consists of four layer, as I have said. So the four layer can be PNPN. Okay, PNPN structure with outer layer referred to as the anode and cathode. Means there are two layers, outer layer, that the first layer is anode and the second layer is cathode. Okay, anode is P type conductor, semiconductor, and cathode is N type semiconductor. Okay, the control terminal of SCR is named the gate. Okay, means the terminal through which we are going to control this SCR is called as gate. Okay, is called as gate terminal, and it is connected to the P-type layer located next to cathode. Okay, it is connected to P-type. Here is the structure: anode, cathode, and these are the three junctions. Okay, P1 N1 develops a J1 junction. N1 P2 develops a J2 junction, then P2 N2 develops a J3 junction. Means it has three junctions, three terminals and four layer. With four layer are P1 N1 P2 N2, and you can see here gate terminal means the control terminal is connected to the P2. Okay, okay. This is the basic structure of SCR. The three junctions are now normally J1, J2, J3. Okay, and these are the means, as we know that transistor is a three terminal, three layer junction, P1 N1. Okay, that means it can be NPN or PNP. NPN means there are two N-layer junction, two N-layer and one P1, okay, NP1, NPN, NPN and PNP. Means if we attach these two junctions, okay, means two transistors, okay, we call it as this is the first transistor and this is the second transistor. If we attach them, then we will get the SCR structure. So we call, we also call this structure as two transistor model, okay, two transistor model. And the schematic diagram of this is shown like this, means anode structure is this, and we have a transistor 1, okay, TR1, in which P1, P2 and N1 is shown. Okay, P1, P2 are the two layers and N1 is the third layer, and through that layer N1 we are going to take one another N1 layer and P2 and N2 layer, and anode, cathode and gate terminal are shown here. Okay, so this is the two transistor model. So how does an SCR works? Load is connected in series with the anode. Okay, means the load is connected with this anode. Okay, load is connected with this anode. The anode is always kept at higher potential than the cathode. Means this, let's suppose this through anode a load is connected here. Okay, so we have to keep this anode at a higher potential. The working of SCR is suited under two different conditions. Okay, so we can see the SCR working in two different conditions. The first condition is when the gate G is open, means the gate G is open, means this gate is not connected to the system. And the second one, when the gate is positive with respect to cathode, means if the gate is positive and the cathode is negative, then also the working can be seen. Okay, so this is the condition when the gate is open terminal. Okay, now we are going to see the working. When the gate is open, means no voltage to the gate, means there is no voltage across the gate terminal, then what will happen? The J2 is reverse bias. Okay, since J2 is reverse bias, and J1 and J3 will be forward bias. For conduction of this SCR, we have to keep all the three in any of the bias condition. But due to no voltage across this gate terminal, then what will happen? The J2 junction will be reverse bias, and J1 and J3 will be in forward bias. Okay, J3 are forward, reverse bias. So that's why no current will flow through the device. Okay, due to that condition, there will be no current flowing through the SCR, and that, so we call that SCR is cut off. Okay, means there is SCR is completely in off condition. Okay, let's suppose this is the diagram. Okay, the positive is connected to the positive P, negative is connected to the N terminal. I mean, this J1, J3 and J1 are positive, but the gate terminal, here you can see the G, gate terminal is open circuited, means open, no voltage is connected. Then what will happen? The current will not flow in the G gate, and there will be no current flowing through the SCR. Okay, then the next point is when the gate is positive with respect to the cathode. Means let's suppose this, you can see here battery, the positive terminal is connected to the positive P, okay, and the negative terminal is connected to the negative. But here you can see the gate terminal is connected with the supply. Okay, means positive of the battery is connected to the gate and negative is connected to the N terminal. So due to what will happen, the electrons from the N terminal, the electrons from the N semiconductor will try to flow or attract the holes. Okay, try to flow, attract the holes. So the current, the electrons will starts to flow from this direction, but it will get a path here. Okay, means such condition is created so that the electrons will transfer from this gate terminal and it will flow like this. But as you know, that conventional flow of current is electrons, the flow of electrons, but our electricity will flow from positive to negative. The electron flow from this direction, but electricity will flow from this direction. Okay, so in this way the electricity is flow. Okay, so J3 is forward bias, means what we have done is here that the J3 terminal is forward and J2 is reverse bias. Okay, the electron from n-type material start moving across J3, right? Across J3 from left side. Similarly, holes move from p-type. Holes move from p-type material towards the right. P-types towards the right. Eventually, the electron that move across J3 are attracted across J2. Okay, means J2 will attract this end. This initiates the gate current, and the J2 is now conducting. Okay, so this is the structure of the, means this is the characteristics of the curve. Okay, we will look this curve, means this is the forward current, reverse current, voltage across anode to cathode, voltage across anode to cathode, okay, voltage across anode to cathode in negative directions. The SCR has three basic states. Okay, the SCR has three basic states. The first is forward blocking mode or off state. Forward blocking mode means in this mode, the state, the SCR operation is such that it blocks the forward current conduction that would normally be carried out by forward bias diode. Means it will block the operation in the forward direction. Forward blocking means it will block the operation in the forward direction. Forward conduction mode means in this mode the SCR has reached into conduction, means such condition is created so that the current starts to flow in the forward direction and it will conduct in the forward direction. And reverse blocking mode means when the process becomes reverse, in this mode state the SCR blocks the current in the same way as that of reverse bias direction. Okay, so this characteristic show that forward blocking means if the SCR is in forward blocking region, means what will happen, it will not allow the current to flow in the forward direction. In the reverse blocking means if the SCR is in reverse blocking mode, then the current will not flow in the reverse direction in SCR. And forward conduction means it will allow the current to flow in the forward direction. Okay. So importance of SCR, it has a small size and gives trouble-free service, reliable, fast action and lightweight, no mechanical part, noiseless operation is there. Okay. So I hope you understand this video. If you have any kind of doubt, you can contact me. So thank you for watching.